hope you're doing well. This video is part of the Citrix NetScaler basics training. What we're going to discuss in this video is NetScaler ADC features, editions, and platform. So what we are going to discuss in detail in the in this video is what is actually the NetScaler ADC. Then we'll talk about its features and purpose, and then we will discuss about the different editions of NetScaler. After that, as we know the different editions, then we need to know how to choose the right edition for your purpose. And after that, in the we are going to discuss about NetScaler platforms. Like, it comes in three models, right? So we're going to discuss them, and we need we will discuss how to choose the right one for your use case. So let's try jump into this. So what is actually the NetScaler? NetScaler is actually a typical load balancer, and it is actually act as even a SSL VPN also, like in a high level. So, but in detail, if you go to that, it has a tons of features, but I have selected only high level few features where we really use in our daily activities. Let's jump straight into this. So the first one is L4 load balancing. What is actually load balancing? Load balancing is typically if you have an application, let's say portal.company.com or a website, it might be a user consuming this service, or it might be a servers also, right? And let's say this portal is hosted on three servers. So what we are doing, we are actually load balancing the traffic. Let's say if one user connects, the traffic will go. If the second user connects, it will go to the second one. If the third user goes, it goes to the third one, right? So this is load balancing, means if one goes down, we are providing availability. Next feature is content switching. What is content switching? Let's say that this portal.company.com/home/webforms. Let's say it has two web pages, like /home/webforms. As you can see in our picture, that the first server has home and web forms. Second server has only homes. Third server has home and web forms, both. So now in this case, if we do typical load balancing, right, normal load balancing, let's say if any of our customer puts /webforms and it is not available here, but we are load balancing. So in that case, what happens? User will not get it. So to avoid that, and to actually not only, I showed a simple example to explain you the content switching, some major organizations will do, they will host each of these in different set of servers, right? So what typically we are doing, example for home, like /home, we will load balance three servers, and for /webforms we will load balance only two servers. So let's say if the user puts portal.company.com/webforms, automatically Citrix NetScaler detects that and it redirects traffic only to these two. That is called content switching. Now next one is global server load balancing, GSLB, or some people will call in F5 terms GTM, right? What is this global server load balancing? Typically, actually think that you have a same set of application running in another region. Let's say this is US, and exactly copy you have in Europe. So now if your user are coming from anywhere in the world, let's say you want to provide regional level availability. And not only that, if you want your users in US, you want them to send to US servers, and if you want to send the users in the Europe to the Europe servers, so what happens, the URL will stay same, but automatically it's a global server, right? So both NetScalers will talk to each other, they detect the traffic, and if the user is from US, it will send the traffic to US. If the user is from Europe, it sends traffic to Europe. That is global server. Now let's go to the next one, application acceleration, client and server TCP optimizations. Here, what NetScaler will does actually, it optimizes the TCP traffic, right, from the client side and from the server side also. This is for accelerating the performance. And the second one is cache redirection, right? Most of the web servers has cache, right? So what it does, instead of keeping the cache here, we can keep the actually host the cache on the NetScaler itself, like maybe some forms and some Java applets and other things we can host here, and so that you will have best performance for your web pages. And let's go to the application security, L7 DDoS defense. It's actually DDoS attacks. DDoS, right? What is DDoS? DDoS means someone program like sending a million requests to this portal in less than a minute or two. What happens? NetScaler cannot handle, and they block typically, right? But if we have this DDoS kind of defense, what happens is it protects that. It knows that there is multiple requests are coming. It's fake, and it will drop that connection. Now, what is rewrite and responder? rewrite is, so let's say if your portal.company.com, this is your old URL, and let's say for your organization changes and certain things, and you change the URL to new one called base.company.com or something, you know. So what happens is, whenever your request will come to this URL, you will rewrite and you will send that, you know, you will rewrite means in the user browser itself, you will put the new URL automatically. That's what rewrite and respond. Actually, mainly for authentication, you know, so for virtual servers. Citrix Web Application Firewall, where you will actually use Netscaler as a typical firewall, you know, like if your web servers have like some credit card, you know, payment gateways and other things, there are known attacks, right? Like SQL injection attacks and other things, you know, Netscaler will protect that, you know, web servers if we have web application firewall feature. N-factor authentication, as it says, N-factor means multiple factors of authentication. The next one is Citrix Gateway. Citrix Gateway is nothing but, you know, it's, you know, it is used mostly for RDP proxy. I mean, let's say you have user, you have server. Example is VDI and other cases, right? The user here in this case only three, right? But in VDI case, you have 1,000 VDIs here. So how the user will know, you know, to which VDI to go, you know, the VDI servers will decide. But how come the Netscaler will load balance that traffic? Actually, it uses gateway feature. So it is used for RDP proxy, SSL VPN, and Citrix ICA proxy, and VMware Horizon PCO, or you know, for PCO or IP implementation, and endpoint analysis also. So for all these purposes, Netscaler Gateway will be used. If you want very detailed information, it is listed in the data sheet. As you can see, I am referring to the Netscaler ADC data sheet. So in this data sheet, you will have all the information. I have left the links for the data sheets down in the description. You can take it from there. You have standard, advanced, and premium edition. What these editions will give? So actually, it gives different features, right? That's the only difference. Let's say we discuss that L4, L7 load balancing content switching. It is there everywhere in all the editions, you know. We are not concentrating gateway and universal license. Actually, this example, that if someone want AAA authentication, this feature is not available in the standard edition. It is available only in advanced and premium edition. So this is how you choose the right edition. What is your, first we need to know what is your requirements. If your requirement need, you know, AAA authentication, or let's say one more important thing, global server load balancing. You see this black dot here means it is available, but kind of not available, right? If you find a blue one, means it is fully featured. All the features are available here. So if you want a global server load balancing, let's say that you know your requirement from day one, that you are going to load balance across different data centers or different cities or different regions, go for global server load balancing feature, which is available in advanced edition only, not in standard edition. So typically experience, I see most of the people will go minimum for advanced edition. They will not go for premium edition. Premium edition, people will go for, like, let's say, you know, like web application firewall. The question is how to choose the right edition. It's very simple. First, we need to know the requirements. If you know our requirement, then we can compare with data sheet and we can find, okay, for this requirement, I need advanced or I need premium. That's it. As simple as like that. Now let's move on. So Netscaler comes in actually three different platforms. One is VPX. VPX means nothing but it's a virtual appliance. By the way, when we talk about Netscaler platforms, VPX or MPX or HTX, the UI, the features, all are same. There is no difference. The user interface, everything, all the features, the way you configure, the way you manage, everything is same. You know, only difference is some are physical, some are virtual. That's it. So VPX means virtual appliance. MPX means it's a physical box. HTX means it's physical, but it has a hypervisor inbuilt in it. On top of hypervisor, there are VPX running on it. So that's called HTX. So we'll talk about detail, you know, when we will use VPX and HTX. So as per Citrix, what is actually the VPX is used for is to deploy, you know, in multiple hypervisors and to give SSL, throughput with no hardware acceleration. That's the only thing, right? The only difference what we don't get with VPX is, you know, it's a virtual appliance, right? So you don't get real hardware acceleration. So it is best used for virtual platforms and load balancing on premise and in cloud and all the cloud, whatever the Citrix ADC is available in all the clouds, is actually the VPX only. And if you are trying to replace any hardware you have, the old hardware, and if you want to go and standardize everything as a virtual, VPX is a good option for you. We will go through the data sheets of VPX later. We will see actually, don't think that a VPX virtual means it's a small, maybe 100 MB, 200 MB, 1 gig. No, actually you can go massive with VPX. So next is MPX. MPX is built for, cloud scale and performance for SSL needs. This is what important. If your application or your, whatever, like maybe you are using, mostly NetScaler is used for VDA and workspace, right? If you know you are doing it for a big customer, if you know that it require a lot of SSL throughput and it is, it consumes a lot of traffic, then best go for MPX, right? Because this is good for managing, web application with multiple gigs of traffic and high performance, right? Particularly if you are enabling any security features like a WAF and other things, it's always recommended to go with MPX, not VPX. It's not a good idea, right? So, and another thing is high performance. As you already know, it's a physical box, so it will give more performance. Why physical will give more performance? If you want to know more details, please check the link down below in the description, and at the end of the video also I had kept the link. So where it's about the hardware platforms, and we are explaining the hardware, so you'll know the details there. The third one is SDX, which is fully isolated multi-tenant support. Actually, it is supporting hypervisor based appliance with virtualization, and it is mainly used for consolidating multiple physical load balancer. Let's say that you have an MPX for internal, MPX for DMZ, MPX for development, and VPX for something. Maintaining all of them will be difficult, right? Let's say all these MPX boxes came to end of life. The best approach is to buy one SDX box, because SDX is actually a physical box, and on top of this SDX, you will run multiple VPX for each tenant. So what happens is, don't think that when we talk about VPX, you will not get performance. No, in SDX, you are guaranteed you will get performance, right? So support fully isolated tenants. Mostly the SDX is used for multi-tenant use case, and like some customers, they use for DMZ and external, one set of MPX, internal another set of MPX, right? Rather than doing that, it's better to go with SDX. Just to give you a heads up, before we go into the data sheets, Citrix has came up with something called pool licenses. What is this pool license now? So now in your, in the previous slide, we discussed that how to choose the right edition, right? Now we choose how to use the right platform. So very simple. If you decided that you want to go with the enterprise edition and you want more performance, the answer is very simple. Go for NetScaler MPX and advanced edition, right? Simple. So, but how to choose which edition in MPX, we'll go through it later in the data sheets. Now, Citrix came up with something called pool license. What is this pool license? It's very simple. NetScaler, Citrix is giving NetScaler dummy box. You will buy the licenses in a subscription model, like 3 year, 5 year and all. So what happens is, the advantage with this is, after 3 years or 5 years or let's say 7 years, your physical box end of life is there. You will just replace the physical box. You still own the licenses. But in typical MPX, what happens is, or STX, whenever you buy these appliances, after the end of life, you throw them. So whatever is your investment, it is fully gone. So if you are planning to buy MPX or STX in near future, go for pool license. You will save a lot of money. So now let's go to the data sheets. You need, like, let's say 200 gig throughput, right? And HTTP request per second is around 5.5 million, right? So then this model is the right choice for you for MPX. Now let's say if you want to buy MPX today, and maybe you want to upgrade it to SDX later, then always look for options where MPX slash SDX is there, like this. What is the difference is very simple. You buy MPX today. In future, if you want to upgrade, just what happens, you will swap the hard disk with another hard disk. It will automatically become SDX. That's the difference, right? Only thing is, you need to take the configuration out and re-import it again. That's the only difference. So this is the difference between MPX and SDX. Mostly, the features are there, all other things, you can go through it. So SSL throughput, how many gigahertz, another things, ICA proxy. This is another important thing. If you are looking for VDI project, if you are sizing for VDI project, okay, you want 17,000 concurrent connections for VDI. Okay, then this is the model for you, right? This is the answer, you know. So now let's try to jump into the VPX model. VPX, as you know, it starts from 10 MB till 100 gig. Guys, VPX means it's not, virtual means it's just not for small customers. No, people use, even I have customers who use only VPX with high throughputs, you know. So because their backend infrastructure is really good. So let's say you want, you know, your requirement is only 200 Mbps. Typically, let's say if you are doing a sizing for a VDI, for 200 users, you go for VPX 200, and up to 300 users VDI, you can go VPX 200. But anything more than 300, like let's say 400 or 500, up to 1000, not 1000 actually, up to 600, 700, 700, go for VPX 1000. If you have more than, 1,000 users or close to 1,000 users, go for VPX 3,000. It's 3 gig actually. It's nothing but actually 10 means 10 MB, 25 MB, 200 MB, 1,000 MB, 3,000 MB. Very simple, right? So this is 1 gig and 3 gig. And question is very simple. How much throughput you need? That's it. Based on the throughput, select it. Or if you are doing sizing for VDI, I told you, you know, rough calculation. So this is how you select. Right. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Actually, I started this series of Netscaler training because I received a lot of requests from many people. Guys, if you need any help, please leave comments below. By the way, you might be interested in my blog, shivashankara.org. And please watch the video till the last because the links are there in the last. Please complete this whole series because it doesn't take much time, maybe 1.5 hours. That's it, max. You will grasp the whole thing, you know, you will understand, and it is a refresh for you. Thanks for watching. Bye.